Now, he was an iconic character in one of the most famous of film franchises. Actor Peter Mayhew played Chewbacca in Star Wars for nearly 40 years.
Gonna give us a roll?
Go on. You do the Chewbacca roll.
He was an absolute icon, wasn't he, Chewbacca? Now, sadly, Peter died in 2019, but now his fans have got a chance to get their hands on some very special movie memorabilia after it was discovered in his loft.
Yeah, let's remind ourselves of the legendary Wookiee warrior.
To gargle and roar at the same time. That's the secret. We're joined now by Angus Ashworth, who's Managing Director of Rydale Auctioneers, who's going to be listing Peter Mayhew's Star Wars souvenirs. Good morning to you.
Morning.
I love this stuff you've brought in. Yes, roaring with approval. I love this stuff that you've found. And to start with, I was expecting it might be figures or props, but it's more interesting than that, really.
Well, it is, really, because it's his own personal bits. I mean, a lot of it is, I mean, the scrapbooks that he's collected and newspaper cuttings and there's various photos, but there's always call sheets from the first two movies, which, you know, you think, oh, it's just a piece of paper, but there's actually the script there. So there's the line from Chewie, if you want to do it down there. You've already done it, but...
What, brackets, roars. growls, actually. There we go. I don't know if you can see it on the camera. Chewie, growls. And that's an actual script, is it?
That's from Empire Strikes Back.
How cool is that?
So, yeah, it relates to the first two original movies. And there's various bits of ephemera and bits that were all found in his old house, in the loft.
You say found in the loft. There's got to be more to it than that.
Well, the couple from Keighley bought a house. You know, Peter Mayhew lived in Keighley in an ordinary terrace house. And they didn't put two and two together at the time. They bought the house. A very tall man showed them around it. And it wasn't until years later, and they were doing some work in the loft, that they found, you know, a box full of all this paperwork. And since then, he, you know, moved to the States and sadly passed away.
But what a find. What else have you got there? I'm intrigued by this pile of stuff you brought in.
There's boxes and boxes more at work, but there's just a small stash. And that's a little scrapbook that he's kept of newspaper cuttings, various photos from the sets.
Am I right to open it?
Be my guest.
Careful, John, I'm nervous.
I love the fact that Chewbacca kept a scrapbook.
Yes.
I mean, that's
just brilliant. With a toy train on the front.
Oh, look, with all his articles about when he got the part.
Oh, about him having giant feet, though.
Yeah, because he was. That was why he got the job, wasn't it, of Chewbacca, because he was over 7 foot.
He was, but originally it was David Prowse who was cast for the job. Mm. He became Darth Vader, and then it went to Peter, so...
There we go.
Watch this space.
I've heard you're a bit of a fan, so we've already got your phone line.
A Star Wars fan, but yeah. Sal was just saying that she thinks you might have from your family growing up. You might have some figures in the attic.
Not from me. I didn't collect Star Wars figures, but I've got an older brother who definitely did. They're just like thrown in a Tupperware box somewhere.
We'll find them.
Shall I? They're not mine.
it doesn't matter. Yeah. Keep it quiet. It's interesting here, isn't it? Looking at these, he was clearly incredibly proud. Oh, look, he's got. Signed photos as well in here. He was clearly really proud of the part that he played in Star Wars and that Star Wars played in his life.
Absolutely. I mean, he's an iconic role, and considering he didn't really have any speaking part, it was purely the motions. I mean, he's one of the iconic sort of characters from it. And
can I just ask the question that everybody shouts at the telly on Antiques Roadshow? You ready?
Yeah.
I know what you're going to ask.
But how much is it worth?
Well, it's a very hard thing to value. We haven't put huge amounts on it. We split it into about 20 lots, and overall probably sort of 1,000 to 2,000. You know, the estimates range from sort of 50 up to a couple of hundred pounds. there's not really
starting at £50.
Yeah, I mean, the sky's the limit, I suppose. The star's the limit, but there's not a lot really to press it on. Now, David Prowse, who played Darth Vader, he died, obviously, recently as well. And one of his call sheets came up for auction just over a year ago. Now, that was signed by him. And for one sheet of paper, that made £400. But it had his signature on, of course. Okay. None of these are signed, because why would they be when we don't go around signing your own call sheets, do you, at home? So,
I love this. There's a letter here. The secretary to George Lucas, director of Star Wars, saying, "Dear Mr. Mayhew, George has asked me to send you this clipping from the San Francisco Chronicle." And there it is, clipped in.
Yeah.
It's the personal nature of it all, isn't
wonderful
it?
Wonderful archive.
You've got as well, what else have you got here? Is that a contract or something?
Yeah, so we've got call sheets. These are all call sheets, so it's got all the characters in there. Mark Hamill, you know, all of them, so...
Details of which Winnebago
oh,
they're in.
I love that. And look, props, gold medallions and chains. Love that.
Just trying to get the reflection off it because it's in this... I tell you, can I take it out? That's great, let's do that. Look at this, the call sheet for making Star Wars, the first series, 1976. Mark Hamill, Carrie Fisher was due in makeup at 7:45 and on set at 9 o'clock.
That's brilliant.
Anthony Daniels, that was C-3PO, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's right.
And now, these days, lots of actors do conventions, don't they? Sign lots of things. Does that make this a bit more precious?
I think so. I mean, it's such a... There's such a strong following for Star Wars, and there's some very, very dedicated fans out there. So I think so. You know, we've even got one of his badges back at the sale room from one of the Comic Cons that he's done with his name badge and things like that. So, yeah, there's going to be a lot of interest, I think.
Don't race off. I'm going to have a look more through more of those. Fascinating. The catalogue showing Peter's Star Wars souvenirs goes live on the Rydell Auctioneers website on Friday. The auction itself is a bit later in the month, 17th of February.